Today, Pete and I are here to tell you about some of the most common mistakes that we see with SHOWIT websites. We'll see if he manages to hang out for this entire video. This kitten was feral, by the way. Not so much anymore, but we were told he would never be a pet, just an outdoor cat. How things have changed. If you don't know me, I'm Galen. I'm a web designer, and I am working with a consulting client right now who purchased a SHOWIT template, and we are going through the website together and basically getting the website ready for launch. And there's so much more that's involved in that process than you would think. You buy a template, you put in your content, your images, your text, your colors, your photos, and you should be good to go, right? While SHOWIT is a really easy drag and drop platform, there's actually quite a few technical things you need to know if you want to have a successful website. One that looks good, one that's easy to use on mobile and desktop devices, and hopefully one that ranks in search too. Mistake number one is ignoring the mobile version of your website. One of my favorite things about SHOWIT is it allows you to completely customize the mobile version of your site separately from desktop. The problem with this is that typically you design the desktop version of your website first. Everything's looking great. You've got all your fonts and your buttons and everything looking exactly as you want them to. And then you go over to preview the mobile version and it looks like garbage. The text boxes are all the wrong size. The buttons don't even look like buttons and the images are completely in the wrong position. Most people do basic mobile optimization as they're building their site, or the template that you purchased is probably already mobile optimized for you. But as you go in and make small changes, you have to remember to go back through and check the mobile version of your site to make sure that everything is functioning properly. The second mistake that I see all the time is not updating your global style settings, your fonts, your colors at the website level. Instead, you're editing them on the page level. When you first get your template, it's going to come with fonts and colors pre-set up for you. And you want to go into the primary style settings of your site and make sure that you're updating those and removing any of the fonts and colors that you won't be using. As a best practice, you don't want to have more than 3 or 4 fonts for your website because it can just start to look really cluttered and it can even impact how fast your pages are loading. Mistake number three is using gigantic or uncompressed images. SHOWIT is often used by a lot of visual creatives, so photographers or personal brands, and they often have really great images that are super high quality. But if you're not resizing your images before you upload them to SHOWIT, you could really be negatively impacting your page load speed. For every website I work on, I resize the images to about 2,500 pixels on the long end, and then I will also run them through a compression tool. My favorite one is Image Optim. I'll put the link in the description below. A quick SEO tip, you also want to be renaming your images before you upload them to SHOWIT. Use a few keywords in the file name separated by hyphens that describe what's actually in the image. Mistake number four is poor heading structure. Not only is this important for SEO, it's also important for anybody who is experiencing your site through a screen reader. We always want to be thinking about accessibility. When I say heading structure, I mean properly tagging the text on your page in the text property settings so that you have an H1, an H2, H3, paragraph, etc. Think of each page on your website like a book. The H1 is the title of the book. You only have one title per page. And then H2, these are like the chapters of the book. And H3s are like the sections within those chapters. And then P's or paragraphs are just the paragraphs of the book. Setting text properties can be a little bit tricky in SHOWIT because there's no visual cues on the page that tell you what's an H1 versus an H2 or a paragraph. To check, you actually have to click into each text element on the page, go over to the text property settings and look it up there, which is really time consuming if you have a ton of different text elements on a page. I created a Chrome extension that makes this process so much easier. You just open up your website in a browser window, you click on the Chrome extension, and you're able to then see all the headings next to the text on the page so you can see which ones you need to fix. I'll include a link to that in the description below if you want to check it out. Mistake number five is not customizing your 404 page. You know when you type in the wrong URL and you end up on the page not found page? That's the 404 page. By default, any template you purchase should automatically have a 404 page for the main pages of your SHOWIT website, as well as for the blog pages of your SHOWIT website. They could just be a copy of one another. But if you bought your SHOWIT template and you never went in and customized those pages, they may still have some placeholder content, and that's gonna be awkward if somebody lands there and it's missing key information. If you're not sure where to find those, you should just see them in the sidebar along with all the rest of your pages. And go edit them now if you haven't already. Mistake number six is forgetting to set up your SEO settings. Every page on your SHOWIT website has SEO settings associated with it. That means you can go in and edit the page title and meta description, and you wanna have a unique page title and meta description description for every single page on your website. If you need more help with SEO, please go check out my workshop series. You can find it over on my website, or I will link it in the description below. There are 3 super helpful workshops that will give you a strong foundation when it comes to SEO, so you can make all these changes to your own site yourself. Especially if you are using ShowIt with WordPress, you're gonna wanna make sure that you've got an SEO plugin set up and ready to go. 2 of my favorites are Yoast and SEO Press, and I'll link both of those below as well. Mistake number 7 is not using the align buttons properly, or just in general, having misaligned elements all around your website. Consistency is key if you want to have a strong user experience. That means having consistent styles across your buttons, across your text sizes and spacing, and making sure everything is neatly aligned on desktop and on mobile. ShowIt has these great little align buttons that really make this process so much easier, but they're not gonna do anything for you if you don't use them. I'm also gonna put a link to my ShowIt design hacks video up here. Highly recommend you go check it out. It will definitely help you speed up your process. Mistake number 8 is not checking for broken links, especially if you bought a template. There are going to be tons of links set up all across your site that you may or may not know about or you may not be using. So click each and every one and make sure that it goes somewhere. And better yet, run your website through a broken link checker like Uber suggests and make sure that there's not any more broken links that you might have missed. Just the other day, I was going through a client's website. I'm helping her with some SEO related work, and I noticed that there were all these links to these pages that didn't exist. It turns out that there was an entire portfolio section of the template that she never ended up using, and all the links to those dead portfolio pages were still live. Definitely something you want to take care of sooner rather than later. Mistake number 9 is not checking your mobile navigation. Your website is most likely being experienced more on mobile than it is on desktop, meaning it's really important that your mobile experience is strong. When was the last time you visited your website on your own phone and actually tested the process of navigating around to different pages to make sure it's working properly? If it's been a little while, that's okay, but I highly recommend you do that now. Like, pause this video and go do it now. A lot of times on mobile websites, the nav doesn't even open properly, or some of the links are broken, so it's really important to check it out. Mistake number 10 is not removing hidden sections or pages from your website before you launch. Most templates that you buy come with a ton of different pages and sections, and you're probably not gonna be using all of them. And instead of just making it so they're not visible, you actually want to either unpublish them or delete them from your website. Because in some cases, Google can index that content even if you don't want them to. If you're nervous about deleting sections or pages that you might still be using, you can always duplicate your website and take a backup of it in your ShowIt dashboard before you make any major changes. It's never too late or too early to spring clean your website. If after all this, you're still feeling stressed about your website, don't worry, I got you. I'm gonna leave a link to my Power Hour below where you can book me for an hour. We can go through and clean up your website together. Or if you haven't decided on a template yet, I will include a link to some of my templates in the description below so you can check them out and see if they'd be a good fit for your business. I've done a lot of the upfront legwork to make sure most of this is taken care of before you even get into editing your site. Thanks so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, like this video, and let me know in the comments below, what's your biggest struggle with ShowIt? Maybe I'll make a tutorial on that next.
These two are getting kicked out of my office for being naughty and loud when I'm trying to film. Aren't they just the cutest though? Love them.